It's me. Just me. Just Trey. We out here. Sizzle Adonis. XFO Week 7 Game Highlight Commentary. I told you, boys. I fucking told you that I was going to stay on top of this one. I told you.
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
Let me tell you something.
We don't care. We out here. Gang, gang. We're just going to get right to it. Look at the screen, boys. Week 7 game highlight commentary. Another week of watching, what's his name? Paxton Lynch suck ass. Quite frankly. That nigga trash, bro. That nigga's trash. Also, what is his fucking name? AJ McCrahan's wife is hot. Just repeat that for the people.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Hold My Nugget Studios once again. Butterfingers!
Stop! Grab it, man! Grab it!
Good Lord, game just started and the Battle Hawks already turned the football over. Stripped that man against his will like he was a Satanist priest in the Catholic Church. Let's try this again. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Hold My Nugget Studios once again for your 2023 XFL Week 7 Game Highlight Commentary. To Orlando we go, where the winless takes on the undefeated, and straight out the gate, the defenders find the end zone, convert on the two-point conversion, and lead 8-0. Meanwhile, for the violent fellatios, they're desperately trying to snap themselves out of a two-game losing streak after starting undefeated.
Yoink.
The bad mojo continues, intercepted by St. Louis. Think fast. Hold my nuggets. Suck my dick. The Brahmas making sure that the Vipers can smell what they cooking on a magnificent back shoulder fade for the score. Kurt Benkert making his first XFL start, found Brown for the score, but they'd failed to connect on the two-point conversion. Wait a minute. The Guardians answer right back, march down the field
Guardians,
with ease,
huh?
And find the end zone. Following the score, they tried to go for one, but their option ran out of options. It'd be no good. 44-yard field goal for the Sea Dragons through the uprights, and it's good. They lead by 3 over the Renegades.
You could have seen this video early and ad-free. Make sure to join on patreon.com/chiseledadonis, and you won't have to worry about ads. What are you waiting for? Click the link in the description.
Despite being doormats all season, Orlando came to play. Dormady looking towards the end zone. Got his man. Magnificent catch. Touchdown. The Guardians have the lead. This man had a 9-yard cushion and still got burnt. He graduated from Josh Norman University. Take that, brother, to Cinnabar Island. Back to Las Vegas we go. Vipers on the move. Sean Price taking the defender to the altar. Get your bitch ass off me, pussy. Magnificent stiff arm into the end zone. Touchdown. Vegas evens up the score at 6-6. Then on the two-point conversion, they'd give San Antonio 2 for their mistakes. The Vipers are in front. Ensuing drive for the Renegades. Plit play action fake, looking like a brother who can't bring a woman to orgasm. Pressing every single button, but ain't doing nothing. Taking down for the sack at midfield. Still knotted at 0 apiece, but not for long. McCarron with the fade to the end zone. Touchdown, Battlehawks. They take the lead. DC refusing to be denied, trying to defend their undefeated streak into the end zone. Regain the lead over the winless Orlando. 36-yard field goal for the Renegades. They even up the score at 3 apiece with 1:45 left to play in the first. Violent fellatios battling back like Taco Bell in the bathroom. The Roughnecks find the end zone to even up the score at 6-6. 3rd and 9 for the defenders. King got a roll towards his left. Throws up a prayer towards the back of the end zone. And Briley Moore, participating in the 5-toes-down challenge, somehow comes down with the football. Spectacular touchdown catch. Look at the educated feet. The balance to get the toes down. The IQ to stay in bounds. What a magnificent catch. Leading by 8, the two-point conversion to make it a two-possession game is good. 10-point lead for the defenders. 33-yard field goal for the Sea Dragons.
Yeah,
they're back in front,
nice.
6-3. The Vipers would do the same. 39-yard field goal to make it a 5-point game in Las Vegas. Ensuing kickoff, Fred Brown fields it at the 4-yard line. He's got nothing but green grass in front. And for the first time this season, the XFL has a kick return touchdown as Fred Brown picks up his second score of the day. 94-yard kickoff return score. Go ahead and give that brother the game ball right now. He scored on offense, scored on special teams. They better throw him out on defense if he gets a pick six. Give him a new contract on the field.
You you need a shout out, book me on cameo.com/chiseledadonis and get a shout out, birthday wishes, draft order for your fantasy football team. It don't matter. Book me. What are you waiting for?
Still knotted at 6 all. McCarron looking towards his left. He's got Butler who takes the football away from the Roughnecks. What a catch. Look how he confiscated the football from the defense. He told that nincompoop to hold my nuggets. Suck my dick. Battlehawks in front. And it was so nice he had to do it twice. They lead by 8. The Vipers drive down the field again. McClendon looking towards his right. Got Smith.
That's tough.
Turn that sucker into a Goomba. Touchdown, That's Las tough. Vegas. They regain the lead. Then on the two-point conversion, McClendon looking towards his left. Got his man in the end zone. 7-point lead. Back to Arlington we go. Plitt takes the snap. Looking to go deep down the field. Got a man.
Wahoo.
But he plays for the other
Only
team.
Two turnovers,
pass intercepted
boy.
By the Z-Dragons. Return to the 42-yard line. They waste little time taking the interception to the turnover embassy and cashing it in for points as Darius Bradwell takes it into the end zone to extend the Sea Dragon lead. And it was so nice, he figured he too would do it twice to make it a 10-point lead and a two-possession game. 25-yard field goal for the Roughnecks through the uprights, and it's good to cut their deficit down to 5. The Guardians still trailing by 10, 2:30 left to go in the first half. Look at the Battlehawk offensive line. They thought they had a free play. The refs ain't throw a single piece of laundry, stupid. You're supposed to block. 2 minutes left to play in the first half. Play action fake for Ben Kurt going down the field. He's got a man. But he plays for the other team. Pass intercepted by the Vipers at the 1 yard line. And Deontay Anderson's going to return it to the 22 before he gets absolutely molested on the progressive sign. On the very next play for McCarron following the sack. 106 left in the first half. The Renegades finally find the end zone. Smith punches it in for the score. How many Smiths are going to score today in the XFL? At this rate, Morpheus, Neo, and Trinity got to be losing confidence.
You want to become an official member at Hold My Nuggets Incorporated? Head over to ChiseledAdonisShop.com and grab your merch. Stock is flying off the shelves. Get it before it's gone. Grab a hat. Let the people know your affiliation.
Flash Gordon approaching.
This always makes me sad. Look at this.
Josh Gordon with an absolute dream of a play. Magnificent catch in the back of the end zone. Participating in the five toes down challenge. Moss and two different Renegades. As Seattle makes it a two-score game once more, they lead by 12. When in doubt, QB sneak it out. For the second time in the first half, the Guardians score on the QB sneak from the one-yard line to make it a one-possession game. Last play of the first half, 59-yard field goal for the Battlehawks through
Making
the uprights and good.
8-point
lead. To the third quarter we go. The Vipers drive all the way down the field, find the end zone again. Two-possession lead for Las Vegas. Got the Brahmas looking absolutely foolish out here. 1-point conversion is good. They lead by 14. 4th-and-1 for Plitt and the Renegades, trailing by 12.
Incomplete.
The Roughnecks gotta do something. 3rd-and-10.
Yeah, come here.
Both teams exchange back-to-back touchdowns in Orlando for the third time today on a QB sneak. Find the end zone and regain the lead. The Brahmas getting the football back after the Vipers do absolutely nothing, trailing by 14 points. Terrell Bonds fields it at the 25-yard line, makes a couple Vipers miss, but he ate
butterfingers.
Fumbles on a play, scooped up by Las Vegas. The Brahmas can't get out their own way. On the very next play, following the turnover.
Fuck out of here.
The XFL's vagina looking to put this game on ice. Ben DiCucci looking over the middle. Pass intercepted by the Renegades. They're not dead yet. And Arlington is going to return it to the 30-yard line. Two plays later, after getting sacked, they do it again.
Hey, where do you think you're going?
Stupid bitch.
To the fourth quarter we go. 29-yard field goal to even it up at 31 apiece. It's no good. He shanked it wide to the left. Orlando giving DC all they got. They may be winless, but they'd show why. Because for the second consecutive week, they ate butter fingers in the clutch. Fumble on the play. Scooped up at midfield by the defenders. I wonder how the Roughnecks are doing.
All right, and nobody's blocking.
The defenders trying to take their receipt to the sperm bank and get their comeback. Pass is complete. Touchdown. DC regains the lead with 11:37 left to play.
Enough from the clown.
Hit the like button and make sure to subscribe. Also, follow me on all social media networks, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at Chiseled Adonis. Make sure you get your fix of all Chiseled Adonis content.
Battle lost in the midst of an interview, but decided they wanted to cough up the ball. Fumble on the play, scooped up by the Ryland Felicios. They take it into the end zone for the score. They cut the deficit down to two. And with an opportunity to tie, they take out their Uno cards.
About new.
Failure. The attempt would be no good. It remains a two-point game, but they pick up a sack on McCarron on the first play of the next drive. Think fast. Here comes the pressure. Latimer over the middle, wide open, one man to beat. Get your bitch ass off me, pussy. Into the end zone. Touchdown. Orlando regains the lead. They've been doo-doo all season, but decided today DC will be the shit. 43-yard attempt for the Dragons through the uprights, and it's good. Arlington is still getting cooked. 5 minutes left to play. Brahmas have an uphill battle. Stripped of the football again. Vegas football. Think fast. 4 minutes left to play. McCarron got his man in the end zone for the score as they take the dead Namekian to the funeral home and put the nail in the coffin. St. Louis wins. Houston loses three straight. The Renegades would cap off an 8-play, 75-yard drive with a score, but did this help them come back and win, though? Absolutely not. You lose again. 30 seconds left on the clock. The Brahmas need an absolute game breaker, but this ain't NFL Street. Pass damn near lost the football. Goes down for the sack. Pack him up. You're going home with another L. 4 seconds remaining. Game on the line for DC. Undefeated streak at large. The kick sails wide to the right. It's no good. And the Guardians have done it. They were winless all season. And today, against the best team in the XFL, the only undefeated team in the XFL is no more, as the Guardians take care of business, get their first victory of the season, and tell the DC Defenders for the first time to join the Houston Roughnecks, the Arlington Renegades, and the San Antonio Brahmas
in taking out
their Metro.
Get a new kicker. He shanked
and
two of them.
Get in aboard.
He's trash.
The
that man's mighty shaky.
Train.
It's over. You lose.
Failure.
Hey, what's the dinner?
Fresh hot ales.
Ew. That's tough. DC, still the best team. Still the best team in the XFL, but they took a loss. Look what happens when you change your quarterback from Paxton Lynch to someone, anyone else, just anyone else. If you like the video, like, comment, and subscribe. I'm out of this thing. Peace.